So while Tomokazu Harimoto's in incredible shape, Zhang Jike has been improving rapidly since Hong Kong 2 weeks ago. And if he continues in this way, he could make it quite a match, but it should be an uphill battle. We'll see. Good backhand to start. Zhang Jike got right back into play. Harimoto making it quite a point. Beautiful backhand from early on, the received game.
One.
This one gets away from Harimoto. Funny, Zhang Jike has an intimidating factor about him in many ways. I feel like Harimoto is pretty fearless. I don't expect to see too many points going this way. Zhang Jike a bit behind the table, a bit soft. Harimoto missing the shots with Jike behind the table. Oh, fast long serve. He's able to turn and get the forehand from the middle of the table to play wide. This is where the speed is really needed to cover the table. If you don't have that, if you can't move, you have to make a big shot, stay close. Fast long serve, big shot right after.
Got it.
It's a tough way to win it. Again, an injured player, one big shot to finish the rally. What level of pain is Zhang Jike feeling? We don't know.
Got it! Go!
This has always been the question with Zhang Jike. The question, well, there are a lot of questions here. No matter how much he wants it, what if he really wants it? Could he still win it? And then the question is, how much does he want this?
Go!
And I imagine he'd want it quite a bit. After all, this is the same 14-year-old that beat Ma Long, Zhang Jike's friend and teammate. It's the same 14-year-old that beat Zhang Jike 4-0 just a week ago. Slows it down a little bit for a spinny backhand instead of the power on the first one. Still Harimoto leading by two. Soft flip from in near the table. Jike within one. Now it's easier said than done, but one thing that we at home watching this on TV or online, ITTV, wherever you're watching right now, you have a chance to see the space of the court. From overhead, Harimoto, if he can stay a little bit closer to the table, you'd imagine can hang in there for the rallies. He's going to be a little bit more comfortable in controlling the angles as well and keeping pressure on Zhang Jike. After all, Jike's getting away from the table.
Got it.
But from just a step behind the table, he'll have one big shot. He's got the power to do that. And unless it comes right back into that sweet spot, the next shot should be slightly softer. It's going to be up to Harimoto to hang in there for the change of spin. Three in a row for Zhang Jike. Right down the line. Good combination here. It's interesting, Zhang Jike is probably thought of to be the best backhand in modern history in men's table tennis. Solid forehand flick here. Harimoto also A lot of hype being built up about his backhand. The more the world starts to watch and learn, the more they realize how strong Hatemoto's backhand is. When you have a player who's a little bit slow or injured, you have to take advantage of the movement. Tries to play it behind the momentum. Short side of the table. Zhang Jike up 2 points. Last night, Hatemoto came in. There was a long line of fans waiting at the hotel. Getting a little taste of what it's like to be Zhang Jike. I think the factor security isn't really needed yet for Hatemoto. Could be in the future. Zhang Jike still has a whole squad of security when he plays the China Open, specifically for him. That's how popular he is in China. Backhand rip right off the serve. In near the table. This is where he's most threatening. And he can dictate a bit where Zhang Jike is going to have to deal with the ball. Not right into the backhand cleanly. A little bit wider to the backhand side. Nine all Hatemoto with the serves. Ooh, top of the net and out. The decisions are right. He played the parallel well. Tried to hug it down the line with some side and topspin. Game point to Zhang Jike. Oh, what a backhand to finish. Clean and wide. Zhang Jike takes game number one. Couldn't get a game in their last match. Takes the first one here. A bit of momentum, a bit of confidence and belief. He'll deal with the pain later, but he will fight this match till the very end. Game number two coming up right after this. Back for game number two. Now this makes things quite interesting for me. I think the way Hatemoto's been playing, he would be the strong favorite in the eyes of many, especially considering their last encounter. But Zhang Jike, the underdog here by world ranking, takes the first game and the first point. Sports psychology, a real deal. A mental game out here, belief.
Two, one.
Trying to take advantage of maybe the slower movement, the issues on Zhang Jike's side. He's still moving around a bit, changing up his receive game. Catch me if you can. I mean, even if we never see the Zhang Jike that we saw from 2011 to 2014, shots like that just light up a sense of excitement in the table tennis world that we will get some decent percentage of Zhang Jike's best back on the table, that we can see points like this played. Ooh.
One.
Break off the edge here for Hatemoto. Softer ball out in front. Zhang Jike just misconnecting. But I'm impressed with Zhang Jike's movement. considering everything, he's able to turn. He's had forehands and backhands from at least forehands from both sides.
4-2.
Didn't see what happened there. Not sure if it caught his shirt or he blocked it on the way down. Be nice to see a replay of that at some point. Oikai onegaishimasu. Don't know if it'll make it into the highlights, but John Jiko right now up 5-2. Again, this sense of self-belief when John Jiko's playing some of these big shots, it could be quite deflating and discouraging.
3-5.
Pretty scary foot stomp there. Frustration. John Jiko going for broke, stepping around. I thought it was just going to be one shot. In that rally, it was. It was that shot or nothing.
3-6.
And we have to give credit, of course, to Zhang Jiko and Lin Gaoyuan, but this reminds me of when Hatemoto played Lin Gaoyuan. He just wasn't really able to play his game or get his shots in.
7-3.
And the details of that, again, it's credit to the opponent. When Hatemoto looks off, yeah, he might be. But that's the way real-time sports work, like this, where there's offense and defense. And you're reacting to somebody in real time. 4 points ahead, Zhang Jiko with the serves. Good counter exchange here. Hatemoto within three. Still a ways to go. Little bit flatter ball deep to the corner. Hatemoto within two at the second towel break. Still gets a little bit of side spin on that Chiquita. But when he comes in his earlier matches against Lee Sang-soo, for example, today, Hatemoto put a lot of side spin on it. It really made it kick. I don't know the details of Zhang Jiko's physical condition right now. But he's moving well. Handling side spins. Here's the reverse pendulum serve, a serve that Zhang Jiko is quite familiar with delivering. And look at that receive. Chiquita out wide.
9-5.
I was hoping it would be a close match, and I was hoping we would see Zhang Jiko in good form. But I'm really surprised to see the scoreboard the way it is right now. Imagine I'm the only person watching this, imagining all sorts of different scenarios here. Again, the match could still very much go either way. A big point here. Zhang Jiko looking at a 2-0 lead if he can take one of the next few points here. Underspin. Rare occasion again. This is something that we saw more in the women's game that's making its way into the men's game. It's used wisely here. Still 2 game points left for Zhang Jike. And he takes game number 2, a 2-0 lead. Is the Phoenix rising? Is Zhang Jike back on his way up? Well, he's on track right now. 2-0, we'll be back for game number 3. Hatemoto versus Zhang Jike right after this. Back for game number 3, Zhang Jike leading 2-0 over Tomokazu Hatemoto. At this point, Ma Long was down 0-2 and would lose this game. So Zhang Jike to start with the serve here in game 3.
Got it!
I'm thinking about the preparation factor. You have a lot of video footage of Zhang Jike and his skills over the years. But in recent history, if you watched videos, you're getting a different match than you saw last week in China, the week before in Hong Kong.
1-1.
Sets up like a shovel serve. Straight back rotation. Plays it down the line from the forehand side. What a step around to get that backhand into play. Oh, Zhang Jike getting angry. Now this is a position I think Hatemoto has to keep himself here close to the table. Probably the third shot that Zhang Jike went with here. That was the real heat. And Hatemoto right on top of the table. Tempted Zhang Jike to make it twice in a row. Big opening backhand. This is more of the Hatemoto that we've seen this tournament. With Lin Gaoyuan, it never came out. He just wasn't able. I think he got 1 game maybe. Came out for a little bit, but for the most part, it just didn't feel like he was playing his game. Here, have to wonder if Hatemoto's been turned on yet.
4-2.
First towel break, 2 points between them. 2 points can quickly be recovered. Hatemoto really needs this game for some confidence. We saw Mima Ito come back from down 0-3 against Chun Xing Tong. Hatemoto has been the talk of the planet since beating Ma Long, the dictator. Gambare Hatemoto, they say.
4-3.
This is an interesting point here. Hatemoto that far behind the table after chasing down the forehand. A little softer on the opening backhand. Getting Zhang Jike to take it back. Get him out of position, move him around a little bit for the down the line blast. Again, the fastest backhands we've seen down the line were against Ma Long from Hatemoto. Once again, the combination, corner to corner. For me, this is what has to happen. Hatemoto stays close to the table. His backhand is not just powerful, not just versatile, it's unpredictable. Yes, that's part of versatility, but I mean, you can't read where it's going so easily, so he can find that wide forehand corner quickly without you knowing it.
6-4.
Touch game, and Zhang Jike back within 2. shorter strokes. Hatemoto making sure he stays on top of the ball for the power. He went to the forehand of Zhang Zhikou a little bit early in the point, not quite as aggressively or as wide. But that's why the rally went the way it did, and he got into the passive position.
5-7.
Second towel break, still within 2 points. It's funny, there have been a lot of little things that Zhang Zhikou has done so far. And no umpire has said anything to him yet. Sort of controlling the pace, working on Zhang Zhikou time. ZJKST, Zhang Zhikou standard time. Said it before, I'll say it again. Hatemoto needs this game for belief, for hope, for rhythm. To put some doubt in Zhang Zhikou, to put a dent in the confidence of a man with persistence tattooed on his shoulder blades. To Chiquita. Zhang Zhikou within 3. One more point here for Zhang Zhikou. We might see a timeout, even though Hatemoto won't have a serve left.
7.
I think I would call it. I'm watching Kudashima in the corner. It looks like he's saving the timeout. Stands up to applaud his player. The timeout. Not at 9-7. Next point.
Timeout.
Hatemoto could make it 10-7. You think maybe you could save the timeout for later when it's more needed? But now or never, you don't want to be down 0-3. Push came. Opening backhand receive. Just trying to read what I see here on screen with body language for Hatemoto. Again, when he takes the opening receive, if he can play it wide enough, maybe a little bit onto the body, right on the crossover point, and follow up wide to the forehand. If Zhang Zhikou turns, shovel serve worked well. One time I saw it used. But still not a game yet for Hatemoto. I expected another 4-0 victory. Hoped for a tighter match. But it makes things really interesting. Quite frankly, either way, but especially for me, if Hatemoto takes this game here, it'll put a bit more pressure from a stamina standpoint, from a belief standpoint, on Zhang Zhikou. It'll also bring a more confident Hatemoto to the table, a bit more loose and free,
8,
less hesitant,
9.
Less tentative. Still 1 point in the lead. Hatemoto on the receive back from his timeout.
Oh,
no, Chiquita pays off in the back arch.
No.
Getting quite bent back for that. It is 2 game points for Tomokazu Hatemoto to really cash in the timeout. He needs to take this game. Not yet. Good placement on the receive over the table. Zhang Zhikou aggressive. One more game point left. The crowd trying to lift Hatemoto. Big backhand does it. Hatemoto with the fist bump, the back bend, and the game. It is 1-2. Tomokazu Hatemoto is on the scoreboard, and we will be back. Game number 4. This is getting interesting.
fourth game.
Back for game number four.
Aramoto serve. Love ball.
Arimoto will start now with the serve and a bit of momentum after taking the last game by just 2 points, 11-9.
One.
Fast long serve into the middle. Serve again.
Go.
Sure, you saw the way he changed the grip of his racket before delivering the serve. Held the racket upright, suggesting shovel serve, just a little bit different.
Got it.
One, two.
Strong start and finish to the point from Zhang Jikuo. Takes a few shots. Again, he's not going to look to get into the long rallies. Slower player generally should try to finish the point quicker.
Got it!
Three,
got it!
One.
Got it!
Feel quite encouraged after that. Arimoto, right before the service toss, had to deal with one quite penetrating voice saying, "Zhang Jike Jiao." There's the gambare for Arimoto. I think that'd be really funny if the crowd united here to get back. Said, no, this is our house. We're here in Japan, home court advantage. And all said, Gambate, Arimoto, Arimoto, Gambate. 5,000 people, however many are here right now.
Six.
Little apology for the top of the net, but Arimoto up 6-2. I still can't believe Zhang Jike took the first two games. Just watching, it's amazing. Arimoto making it his own, getting the early attacks, hanging in for the first one. Convincing lead here in game number four.
Got it!
Two.
Eight.
Almost looked like it caught the hand of Zhang Jike on the kick. Two serving eight. Points are starting to go quickly.
Left. 2-9.
Very confident backhand attempt. Second towel break. Zhang Jike still down by six. Clever idea, but right into the body. No timeout left for Arimoto. Right now, quite frankly, no need. Around 9-6. If that score were to come to be in this game, you'd expect he'd have one. Outstanding point once again. Zhang Jike making some big shots right off the bounce. For example, slows it down just a little bit, goes for the big counter. Six game points to Arimoto. Two games apiece, tied up. The most dominant game we've seen yet. Arimoto 11-4.
Fifth game. Zhang to serve. Love all.
Back for game number five. Tomokazu Arimoto on the receive with the momentum has tied it up. Zhang Jike looking to turn things around, get this game for a 3-2 lead.
One, love.
Earns himself the forehand attack, turns and plays the wide one. the corner. Exciting to watch these backhands go at each other. Again, Zhang Jike, historically, just a few years back, the best backhand in the world. Tomokazu Harimoto. Incredible backhand as well, but here Zhang Jike takes it from over the table, creating that wide angle surprise factor. Start for Zhang Jike again. He doesn't want to come into game six having lost three games in a row. Wants to feel like just one more game, that's all I need. I can push, I can find it.
One.
Sometimes a difficult task looks much more doable when you realize you're almost there, just a little bit more. But when it's still far away, there's just this sense of, I don't know, it's too much work. Conversation as we come into the towel break. Harimoto has beaten Ma Long. Does that mean he's better than Ma Long? Definitely not. Does it mean he's capable of beating Ma Long again? Absolutely. But 2-0 against Zhang Jike would sure be nice. For Harimoto, that is. For Zhang Jike, getting his revenge on his way back up. Working hard, he's talked about it explicitly that he wants to play Tokyo 2020. And he's going to do everything he can to take care of himself, give himself the best chances to represent China in 2020.
5-3.
So up by 2 points, about halfway through this game. Zhang Jike making a real case for himself here. Now this feels a bit more like game one. Easier said than done, but you could see the hands of stress in the background from some of the Japanese supporters. When Harimoto gets passive, it's rarely a good thing for his chances, especially against a player who's a little bit slower, whether it's injury, anything else. Good placement here, good kick, the side spin making the ball bend into that elbow. Zhang Jike is some serious trouble off the bounce. I mean, that technique should be unrecognizable from Zhang Jike. We just rarely see a shot like that because he's not dealing with balls that he can't step around. Soft flip from Harimoto, he's within one. Signature Harimoto move there. This is the game. While Zhang Jike's had some comebacks here. Timeout, Zhang Jike's side. Conversation with Lu Boliang in the corner. I can't hear anything that's being said right now. But it's interesting, when you're a celebrity at Zhang Jike's level, you have to have security follow you to tournaments, stay in other hotels, keep your whereabouts sort of low key. There might also be this sort of sense of, I don't have to listen to you, but you don't see that. He's been very open to suggestion. He's been very respectful to Lu Bozheng in the corner. I think it's also a big thing in terms of relationship with the coach. If you want to be chosen for the Olympic Games, does the coach have a say? Well, you have to imagine that the coach has some input, even if it comes from higher up in the food chain within the Chinese National Association. but it never helps your chances to not get along with someone in the decision-making position. Well, who has any influence, right?
Five.
Letting
six.
The hand that feeds. He's working hard to make his way back. Stretching it out. Hatemoto with the serve. 1 point behind. This has been a little bit out of character for Zhang Jike so far in this match. Zhang Jike has been strong near the table, especially when he has time for the opening backhands. This has been working out really well for Hatemoto, taking a little extra time in the flip game instead of trying to power it and hit it past Zhang Jike. After all, he's used to the speed. Anyone who's played Chinese Super League or played for the national team knows what speed is all about, probably better than anyone else in the world.
Left. 6-7.
Hatemoto forcing Zhang Jike with that softer flip to move, rebalance, and then take a shot. Hatemoto, you can hear the smack sound on this ball. Just swats it back. This is Kirill Gerasimenko style out here. Hatemoto does it from time to time, but it pays off. How to make your inverted rubber feel like pips. Ooh. Tested here. Hand to the back, was he tucking in his shirt? Was he feeling lower back pain? Definitely tested to the wide corner. How much pressure he keeps on Hatemoto to get another shot back in the opposite way. Still a 1 point lead for Hatemoto here in the fifth. Oh! This is the pattern that was 1 point, and several points have been set up sort of like this. Where Zhang Jike was behind the table by a bit, but the one time I talked about it, where Hatemoto made sure he stayed pinned right at the back of the table in the blocking game. Zhang Jike's gonna have to go cross court, because if he tries to play it to the short side, Hatemoto can play it cross court. It'll be tough for Jike to get back in.
8-9.
Good use of a tight serve. Zhang Jike here, second serve, and a chance to tie it up. At 9-9 in game five, a lot of it comes down to nerves, pressure. How do you perform under pressure? The flat one again! It's that no-spin flat shot from Hatemoto that comes back into the net. Who does that? Hatemoto's done it twice in just a few points here, two out of the last three. And it earns him two game points. He opens strong at the start. Zhang Jike said, okay, you take the first shot, I'll counter it back. I'm prepared for that. But then found himself behind the table. Two game points for Hatemoto.
10.
One saved in the pressure. Pressure continues to rise. Oh, back edge of the table. A break for Zhang Jike. Looking down at the court from time to time. He's stretching out his back. There is an apology. It is really fast. There it is. No questions about that. And he does it at a time to make sure that Tomokazu Hatemoto can see it. Sometimes players apologize quickly and go right back. The opponent never sees the apology. Tied up here, 10 all, game number five. Oh, the flat hit finds the net. He had him out of position. He went for the middle of the table. It's easy to second guess. Thinking if Hatemoto tried to spin that wide with the forehand, it would really test the footwork of John Jikura, considering where he took that last shot from. Tough to fault Hatemoto. He's made that shot two times successfully to win points. Game point to John Jikura. Three in a row from down 8-10. Oh, the slow spinny one. Game. Leaves open the forehand side. He turns the corner. A 3-2 lead for John G. Ready. So it is a 3-2 lead. Zhang Jikuo making this a very questionable victory for Hatemoto, and quite frankly, the biggest victory he's had in a long time. If Zhang Jikuo could take this title,
sixth game,
even in the semifinals,
Hatemoto to
he
serve.
Was the last
Love
Chinese all. Male in the tournament. And with the strong second string of Japanese men here. And the best player in the world, Ma Long. To have no other Chinese players in this semifinal, quite a shock. Getting the tongue of the shoes straight. Hatemoto down 2-3 now to start game six with the serve. Clever idea, just missing the corner. First point to Zhang Jikuo. Pressure on that ball. I mean, it sits up high. That's a tough feeling. You get the opportunity and you want to do a lot to it. Table tennis players can relate. That one that sits up high and you're just thinking, I'm going to hit this ball so hard it's going to split into pieces, and then you don't touch it.
Let. Two, love.
For Hatemoto, he needs to get the wheels rolling here. Still early in the game. But again, the way Hatemoto plays every point, and even just being down from a momentum standpoint, from a confidence standpoint, being down 0-2 before this, tough way to go. Big point for Hatemoto. Funny, I have had some conversations with Zhang Jikuo here and there over the years, but a bit more of a private person. Hatemoto in recent years had a chance to see a lot. The intimidation factor when he's fighting is interesting. There it is, smothers it down the line. Gets Jikuo away from the table, makes his way back in on top of the bounce. That was the passive one. And the second arcing forehand like that. We saw this against Jin Ueda. Follow-up shot, Zhang Jikuo played backhand down the line for a winner, but not this time around. First towel break, and Hatemoto in good position here. 4 points in a row from down 0-2. I was going to say the intimidation factor, the fight. If you didn't know Hatemoto at all or hear him in interviews, if he was a little bit more private in some ways, you think, man, this guy's intimidating. Physically, of course, stature makes a difference too. Tattoo here and there could help.
3-4.
Again, I'm waiting for Feng Yaolan to break out into the scene, tear off a jersey in celebration. Revealed to the world some of the most beautiful link I've seen on the scene. So a 2-point lead for Hatemoto maintained. To the length of the table, that cross-court forehand. What would it mean for Hatemoto to win this match? It would mean a lot of things. Confidence. You've beaten Ma Long. You've beaten Fan Zhendong. Zhang Jikuo 4-0 once. No, oh, wider and wider. Zhang Jikuo moving back into the table. Hatemoto just keeping the ball in play with some topspin, trying to keep it baseline, but not quite the force that we've seen from him. Again, away from the table a little bit, allows more time. Smart move from Zhang Jikuo to come back in. And on the other hand, what would it mean for Zhang Jikuo? It would be incredible encouragement after two tough losses 2 weeks in a row. That flip doesn't have to be the most powerful, still relatively powerful. Watch one more time. Yeah, that's fast enough for sure. I mean, no question, just based on the outcome.
Seven.
Tight serve. Zhang Jikuo keeps it inside the table. Hatemoto can't steal the attack. Last game, Jung Ji-kil was able to pull it out. If I remember correctly, he was trailing for a good portion of the game. Yeah. 10-8. Harimoto. Two game points saved by Jung Ji-kil. Top of the net and out. Snowball effect, it has to start gathering. I guess that's a rolling stone. No, maybe it's not, it's a snowball. I wasn't raised with that proverb. Okay. Oh, power in position. Jung Ji-kil doesn't move too early. He waits to see where Harimoto is gonna go. Feels it's likely it's coming back to the forehand, the safer shot. So he waits there. Counters it back even wider. The angles that Jung Ji-kil has been able to produce from behind the table make him very dangerous.
Seven, eight.
Right down the middle of the table. Harimoto looking under pressure to put some pressure on himself. A bit of a flip. Jung Ji-kil saying, I'd like to wipe my sweat real quick. I'm just going to grab my towel. Normally people ask. He's just saying, just a heads up, I'm going to do it. I'm sure you'll grant my wish. One down, second serve for Jung Ji-kil. Ooh, the spinny backhand. Harimoto maintains and gets back that two-point lead. I'm nervous watching from here, but I can't imagine what it's like to be in the corner for Coach Kurashima, a match at this level. Spinny backhand, three game points. Two wasn't enough to get the 3-2 lead. Is three enough to send it to a deciding game seven? I know the world would love to see it, regardless of who wins. Doesn't stop. Harimoto with the apology for the back edge. But 11-7, he sends us into the decider. Well, wah, wah, wee, wah, this is going to be quite a thrilling match. Look at the scoreboard. Decided in the decider. Grab your snacks, call your friends, get your hydration ready. Put a towel behind you because you won't need your whole seat, just the edge. The decider coming up right after this. Nothing makes a stadium look more beautiful than having people throughout it, thousands of fans here in Kita Kyushu, Fukuoka, Japan, watching live as Jung Ji-kil tries for his comeback to take this title, and Harimoto tries to continue the streak that he's been on after beating the dictator and beating Lee Sung-soo earlier today. Jung Ji-kil to start the decider, game number seven. Softball. Apology from Harimoto. Either way, I like the calm. Shows that his head is in the right place here. He's not panicking. And he goes fast when he has the opportunity. This might be part of the reason Harimoto interviews with such a soft voice, that he just doesn't have much left. So softly spoken.
2-1.
First point for Zhang Zhuko in game number 7. Back to the edge tape. His happy place. Drawstring and shirt tucked in, rubber and the tape.
Ooh. 1-3.
A delayed chole. Sounded like it hit some skin. I'd love to see a replay of that. I'm curious if it caught the neck or if it was lower. It happened so quickly.
1-3. 3.
So score wrong. 1-3, he says. Language barrier for a moment. It appeared. Just an umpire also trying to take in what Zhang Jiko said as well. One serving three now. Soft in the back end. I wonder if Hatemoto is flexible enough to get his head to touch the heels of his shoe. Seen people do it from time to time. He bends so far back. 14 years old, I think the 27th, he'll be 15 if I remember correctly from his dad. No response from the Japanese fans. Oh, the backhand, the wide angle, Hatemoto rocking it out. They're gonna switch sides of the table. There are so many picture perfect, slow-mo moments of Hatemoto in celebration like a rock star. Game number 7, this isn't over yet. We've seen bigger comebacks from both of these players. Serves on Hatemoto's side. The high spinny one. Last time we saw one sit that high, I think it was from Wang Manyu to Mima Ito. Big point for Zhang Jiko. Second serve here for Hatemoto. Hatemoto with a backhand rip like we haven't seen from behind the table. Really, the Hatemoto celebrations are just too cool. A big shot. Watch him turn. Every point that he wins, we get a better celebration from him than half of the match point celebrations from other players around the world. He's a TV production's dream.
3.
Backhand to backhand, Zhang Jiko right off the bounce again, keeping close to the table, keeping the pressure on. An encouraging lead, but far from comfortable and far from over.
Four.
Short point. Quick decision here to set up the power. No timeouts left. Coach Kudashima can speak Japanese to Hatemoto between points. Hatemoto can hear him. He's on the serve again, in position to set up his third ball. But Zhang Jiko shuts it down. Gets in for that backhand receive. This is what it's all about in the modern game. This is why all the top players have that banana, the Chiquita receive. Why they can use the backhand from the forehand side to generate more spin with the tables in the way.
Six.
3-6 wasn't that long ago. Was it 2-6? They switched sides at what, 5-1? It's a fine balance. Playing soft, but playing deep on the table. Positioning is so important. Zhang Jiko's come in, and Hatemoto's played slightly passive, and he's finished the point. He's played high-risk shots down the line, and he's made them. He's countered. He's opened with the backhand.
Got
bold serve and an outright point. The streak continues at least four in a row now. Arimoto straightening the shirt, trying to calm himself. Both players wiping the sweat from their palms near the net on the table. Even down on the sock for Zhang Jike, who's in the lead now for the first time. Game seven. Ooh, this one gets away. Arimoto escapes, hangs in for the big backhands. One, it was a second backhand in the turn with the forehand. From the start of this game, it was starting to look quite one-sided. 7-all. Oh, the touch shot off the net. Zhang Jike gets the break. Arimoto, very difficult ball here. Thought he still had a chance. Bit of side spin, it was right near the edge of the table. He didn't even catch it from over. That's a very difficult shot to deal with. And the crowd getting behind Arimoto. It just got quite cold in here. And this one sneaks past. 2-point lead for Zhang Jike against serve. He takes both of the points on Harimoto's serve. Cleans the table. ZJK time. From this camera angle, it is tough to tell how high this ball is. A little bit more shallow on the table, clearly. This ball goes long. Arimoto within 1 point. Another serve here for Zhang Jike. The rally continues, 9-all in game seven. It will come down to 2 points between these two players. Tomokazu Arimoto could be the future, the best player the world has ever known. When his time comes, still years away, with players like Ma Long and Fan Zhendong in front of him. And Zhang Jike coming back from the past to 9-all. In game seven. The backhand goes out. Match point for Zhang Jike. How bad does he want it? Arimoto hasn't won a point on his serve in his last three attempts. Japan behind him. In the Ma Long Tomokazu Arimoto match. It's never a shame when there's an amazing match, but it's often a shame when the most exciting match of the tournament is a quarterfinal. Not this tournament, the men's singles final after incredible women's singles final. Zhang Jike with the serve. Point. It is not over yet. It is 1 point away from over. 30-year-old Zhang Jike, Olympic gold medalist, Grand Slam champion in the fastest time of table tennis history. It was there! Zhang Jike just exhaling. Wow! Never easy. Shots coming back. But he earned the opening on the forehand side. You might recall when Hatemoto flat hit the ball into the net on the middle of the table, I was thinking, why not counter loop the other way? Well, he tried it here. He went for it. Risky, gutsy play. This is what champions are made of. It's the players who perform under pressure when everything is on the line. Second match point for Hatemoto. Tomokazu Hatemoto face down. 13-11, 4-3. What a save! He saved match point against the best John G. Cook we have seen in a long time. A respectful handshake. An amazing performance from Zhang Jike, but even better from 14-year-old Tomokazu Hatemoto. How much can you take? Japan really got their money's worth here in this tournament. From Mima Ito to Tomokazu Hatemoto, the biggest hug that I have seen from him with Coach Kurashima. It's not his father in the corner. It is everybody in the stadium minus about 20 Zhang Jike fans, sounding like about 100 out here. Tomokazu Hatemoto has stood the test. Not the test of time, the test of consistency, challenge, and performing under pressure. He had ice on his shoulder yesterday. Was on his way to bed early, his hands in the air. The 4-0 victory did not feel anything like this match. A week ago, it was a completely different Zhang Jike. And Hatemoto from down 0-2 and 2-3 comes back. And there's Dad, Yu Hatemoto, coach, father. Wow. Hatemoto. Watashi wa Tomokazu Hatemoto desu. I am Hatemoto. That would be the phrase to be saying right now around the world. We'll take a minute here. Instagram, tweet, Facebook post, whatever you want. This news will be circulating fast, and the highlights will be circulating as well. The ball kids with some good handshakes from a player who will be a legend of the sport. It sure seems the way things are going right now. Stick around, we'll have the award ceremony and the interview coming up with Tomokazu Hatemoto right after this. You're watching the 2018 ITTF Seamaster World Tour Lion Japan Open.